Hello and welcome to this PTGui tutorial series. Today's segment is all about viewpoint correction. And do note that this is a PTGui Pro only feature. So what is viewpoint correction? Well, essentially viewpoint correction helps you to map images into your existing panorama that were not taken from the no parallax point. So you remember from the first tutorial that we're going to great lengths to capture all our images from the no parallax point. So you're rotating the camera, not around the camera body, but around the lens and the no parallax point of the lens. That's all fine, but sometimes there's situations where that's not possible or not desirable. A common scenario, for instance, would be you're just using a regular tripod to capture your panorama, just like shown here with the setup that I used to photograph the tunnel panorama that you all can play with. What happens here is that, of course, you get a hole in the ground or you leave traces of the tripod in the final panorama if you don't do anything special. What could you do? Well, you shift the tripod head a little bit to the side and capture that area unobstructed. But there goes your no parallax point. The images are taken from an offset position or, as you might also call it, from a different viewpoint. Viewpoint correction now allows you to map that image back into the rest of the panorama and to do that more or less perfectly. There's only one big condition that has to be satisfied. The area that you're trying to map back into the original panorama has to be more or less perfectly flat. That is the case here, so that's going to work just fine, as I will show you next. But I also show you at the end of this tutorial a counterexample just to hammer that point. So if you want to use viewpoint correction, make sure that the area that you're trying to map into the original panorama is perfectly flat. Otherwise, you're going to run into big problems. All right, so let's have a look at that process in PTGui. And I'll start off by showing you the correct process start to finish, just so not to confuse you. But then we'll get a bit experimental and we'll show you what can go wrong when you don't follow these steps. So let's get going. Here are our four images from the tunnel that we played with before. And I've now got an additional image, that offset image, in order to fill in that nadir area. So the first step is to enable viewpoint correction. And we can conveniently do this here from the starting screen. The next thing I want to do before aligning images is mask away anything that's not on the ground floor. As I was telling you before, we're not interested in those pixels. So by masking away these pixels, we achieve two things. One is that, well, they don't end up in the final panorama. And the other thing is that PTGui won't actually generate any control points in these areas. And that, of course, is because we don't care about all the other areas, so they don't need to match any of the other panorama images. We really are just interested in that area down here. All right, so that's the two crucial things to do. Enable viewpoint correction and mask away anything that's not on the flat ground. And then we just run align images and we should get a perfect result. There you go. If I optimize again, we'll get this very good verdict. So everything looks great. And here we go. That's a perfectly mapped in floor. So let's start afresh and see what happens if we don't follow these steps. First off, I'll just run align images with no viewpoint correction and no masking done. And we get a pretty horrible result. If I initialize and optimize, we get the bad verdict. So that obviously doesn't work so well. Okay, well, let's enable viewpoint correction then and see if that becomes better. No, we still get the bad verdict. And the reason for that is that we didn't mask away anything from the ground floor. So PTGui actually went ahead and generated control points all over the place, including up on the walls, which is definitely not on that flat area, as I was saying. So I could now go in and prune away all these control points and get a better result. But as I said, it's a lot easier to just mask before generating control points. And that way have PTGui just completely ignore all these areas that we're not interested in at all. A little piece of advice here, where you don't have to get your camera exactly back to that no parallax point position for that offset image, you still want to be reasonably close to where the other images were taken from. And the reason for that is twofold. On the one hand, PTGui's control point generator will have a lot easier time to generate those control points for you in that offset image. So if you don't get any on those, well, that usually means that you've been too far off for PTGui to manage to generate any control points there. And the other reason is that the image, as we're trying to map it back into the rest of the panorama, doesn't need to be deformed all that much if it's been taken close to the original images. All right, and before closing off, I promised to give you another good counterexample, and here is one such panorama. This was taken from the Cologne Cathedral up on the tower. I hope you don't have any vertigo. And as you can see, I spent a little bit of time masking away anything that's not on that ground floor. All right, let's see what happens if we remove that mask. And there you go. That's a bit of a catastrophe, especially in those parts here. The rest of the floor still looks fine, but that area is hugely problematic. And why is that? Well, because it's not on the flat ground. So if we undo this, that's when we get our perfect panorama, and those parts here were taken from that no parallax point. Only the floor image is mapped into place. All right, that about covers it for viewpoint correction, and we'll see you at the next tutorial.